I'm going to rip through a quick screencast. Another, basically Terminal and Vim workflow and the blog for 2020. So things are a little different, but it's basically the same. I got to start over. I screwed up the last video. So, there's a TMUX. I'm going to kill it. So that's a script that opens TMUX. And it runs a push script for any directory like .git folder, pulls, changes, adds changes, commits, and pushes. So, did I just kill it? Forgot. Boop. There it is. It's very ugly. But it's not there to look at. It's there to run in the background. And there's probably a better way to do that. I just bumped into it one day. And that's updating some changes in different projects. Here's another way. Well, should show you the folder. This folder doesn't get checked because it's a dot folder. So there's a click app. What am I doing? It's late. I'm sleepy. Click. Click cookie cutter. Yeah, that's it. Python command line app. So I can push and pull the stuff in that folder. I can list the projects. These are all templates. Cookie cutter templates. I've done other screencasts on those. But a cookie cutter template. Let me just go to open one. Let's say you're going to make a README. So the squiggle brackets, cookie cutter, and then a variable name. So that folder is going to get that name. And then if you have contents inside, see if I can find one. Yeah, there we go. So in a file, you can have the same format, squiggle brackets with a variable name. And the variables, this is very simple and extremely powerful because this is a template for a project using multiple languages. Where is it at? Cookie cutter JSON. So you just put your variables in the default value in here. This is fully, you can automate it on the back end in the command line. And I have a web app, Django, click Django, that I made a screencast on. If you wanted to give it to somebody that is scared of the command line, they can run the same way from a web app with the fields get pulled from the JSON file and put on the web page. Anyway, discursive. So if you wanted to, you could deploy that. If you go to, let me do that. No, I think I did a screencast on this. Let me just run the poll. I should probably put this in my TMUX session now that I think about it. It goes to that folder and it pulls each one of them, the changes in each folder. There may not be any. Nope. So anyhow, that's the Git workflow, multiple projects. And there's a to-do folder. This is a cookie cutter. Actually, I think it's a cookie cutter. I don't know. But in this folder, you really only need three files in here, but this has been blown out from usage. and it's a todo.txt. So that's just a text file with to-do list, but you can do it like this. So that looks at the to-dos, and we'll put a new one in there. So there's test at the bottom when you're done, or you can append it. You can append to it. Test stuff. So now it says test stuff. And when you're done, you type todo 17. I'm going to actually delete it. Yes. Now it's gone. But you can also do you can go list pry. Shows priority ones. You can change the pry. So T pry 5, let's make that a priority F. See that change the priority. Stuff like that. But all these folders have them. Shaneel.com, the new blog. I'll get into that in a minute. Did I not put one in here? Okay, Buddhism. Okay, it's got one. I'm just going to yank it. Here's how you install it if you didn't do it. And then I just got to clear out these files because those are the only three you need. So now if I go to the website, this is a Git repo. Well, let me add one first. So the alias for T equals. Oh, I gotta grip it. Oops. It goes relative to the folder you're in. So you can T and then commands or T edit will take you straight to it. So if I go T edit, it took me to this empty text file. I don't think that file actually exists yet. Oh, it does, probably because I ran the command. So, update changelog. Now this is in here. Make it a priority A. Go back here, and when I run T priority, it's going to look in every folder. So now Shane Knoll's got a priority task. So I can look at all the to-dos. You can also do all, and it'll show all, including with no priority. So that's how I keep track of what I'm doing next. And then when I'm done, I just close them. I'm going to push that so that the to-do app is included. Oh, yeah. This is the new blog. So I write in Markdown. It's going to come out and look like that. Turns it to HTML if you run build. It just turns on the Python VM, runs the makedoc command to build it. That creates the site folder where it marks it all up to HTML. Anyway, I'm not going to go into all of them, but this is a separate site. Sort of meditating. I'll get into the journal, actually. Here's our journal. I don't just journal in the Buddhism site, a journal in any of them. Oh, yeah. Hang on. I didn't actually update the changelog because I want to show you a new shortcut. CL opens the changelog. Boop. RD opens the README. And sometimes I put the changelog here. I can GF. GF is the keyboard shortcut. Jumps between them. So there's three of them right now. The Linux cheat sheet. Search actually works. As well as copy paste. As well as syntax highlighting. It's got these little social links too. Built in. That's all mostly built in. If you want to do one of these, the McDocs and the material theme are right there. What else is new? The tmux session, the click cookie cutter. So that's all the Git repos, and then the blogging workflow. I think I already went over all of it. Maybe some more. Oh, the did I talk about this? Key binding, tab complete, and Vim editing mode. Vim editing mode, JK up and down. Yeah, I think I did do this, didn't I? DW deletes a word, big A, append. Press I to insert and just type like a normal one. But if you do this, tab complete, CD, you can just rotate through everything. It's very handy. Oh, the journal, I was going to show you that. So you would use that alias for FJ, which does a date in this format. I'm actually going to go to the test folder. FJ. And then I usually go like this. Oops. Today's journal. There you go. Here's another way to convert to HTML. I mean, it's easy enough. So it converted that to HTML. You can also do it to just about anything. Blah, 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 blah. Pandoc is ridiculously powerful. So is Cookie Cutter. So is MakeDocs. They're really efficient ways to blow through stuff. So now I just got to do all the content for the cheat sheet site. I have a ton of cheat sheets. I'm going to start with one that I use frequently. Oh, and I'm building more keyboards. See, this one's got a journal in here. I need to update that. I think I'm going to try one of these. Something like this. What's going on here? And I ordered a one of these. It's a little 40% split keyboard. What? Come on. I don't know why it's not showing up. Did I name it wrong? No. There's one. Is there a picture in here? Let's hope so. Yeah, here's one. My internet is slow. Yeah, who cares? It's just a flipping keyboard. I don't know about this color scheme. I think my screen's affected by night mode. Yeah, there we go. Let's see what they look like. Here. This one's blue. This one's pink and lime. And this one's orange. And these other ones are going to get, they're going to get their own site, but for now I just made a page. There you go. Let me just think. There might be more aliases I use. But yeah. That's about it. I think it's a much better workflow than previously because the sync is better and I mean really I think I might set up my own Git repo on this is on the Linode server and I might set up my own Git repo and then I really will be maintaining everything by myself locally. And yeah, that's all I can think of. And it's late and I'm sleepy. Stopping the video and we'll upload it in a bit. Boop, boop. Mm-hmm.